Let's take a tour of our 3D model, Microbes in Action, to explore the main differences between a eukaryotic cell, a prokaryotic cell, and a virus. In this model, the large cell is an amoeba that is in the process of eating a bacterial cell, which is also being infected by a bacteriophage. Let's start by zooming in to look at the bacterial cell. The term cytoplasm is used to describe all of the components inside the cell. It includes the cytosol, a colorless, gel-like matrix composed mainly of water, salts, and small organic molecules, and the bacterial genome. In prokaryotes, the genome is a single, circular, double-stranded piece of DNA that is not enclosed within a nucleus. The bacterial genome is usually referred to as a chromosome, but it has a different structure to eukaryotic chromosomes, as you will see later in the tour. The transcription machinery converts small regions of the DNA genome into messenger RNA, or mRNAs for short. Ribosomes in the cytoplasm bind to the mRNAs and use them as a template to make specific proteins. This bacterial cell is being infected by a bacteriophage. It has attached to the outside of the cell and is injecting its DNA genome into the bacterial cytoplasm. The virus will then hijack the bacterial machinery to make lots of copies of the viral genome and viral proteins. The virus components will then self-assemble into hundreds of new viruses that will burst out of the cell and destroy it. But it looks like this bacterium is not going to survive long enough for the bacteriophage to complete its replication cycle. An amoeba is engulfing or eating the cell by phagocytosis. And the bacterial cell is then trapped inside a phagosome, surrounded by a membrane that formed when the cell membrane pinched off during the engulfment process. The phagosome then fuses with a lysosome, which releases digestive enzymes and causes the inside of the phagolysosome to become very acidic. This destroys the bacterial cell, and the amoeba can now take up nutrients from the phagolysosome into the cytoplasm for its own nutrition. Any remaining components of the bacterial cell that the amoeba cannot use for nutrition are excreted via exocytosis. Now, let's take a look at some of the other structures within this amoebal cell. In eukaryotes, the genome is made of double-stranded DNA that is tightly packaged into structures called chromosomes that are enclosed within the nucleus. The nucleus has a double-layered membrane called the nuclear envelope, which separates the genome from the cytoplasm. In eukaryotes, transcription, the production of mRNAs, therefore takes place in the nucleus. The mRNAs have to be transported through pores in the nuclear envelope before they can be translated into proteins by the ribosomes, which are located in the cytoplasm, and also embedded in the structure of another membrane-bound organelle called the endoplasmic reticulum, or ER for short, which is formed from extensions of the nuclear envelope called cisternae. Near the nucleus, the cisternae are flattened, sac-like discs that are studded with ribosomes, giving it a rough appearance. The ribosomes translate mRNAs and insert the newly made proteins into the ER membrane, or release them into the inside of the ER. These proteins enter the secretory pathway and are passed the Golgi apparatus, which is a bit like a sorting office in the cell. It makes sure proteins go to the correct place. This process is called intracellular trafficking. The Golgi apparatus is also involved in protein modification, exocytosis, and lysosome formation. Mitochondria are membrane-bound organelles, often referred to as power generators because they produce adenosine triphosphate, or ATP for short, the major energy storage chemical. The inner mitochondrial membrane is embedded with the components of the respiratory electron transport chain and is highly folded into cristae. The inside of the mitochondrion is filled with a gel-like matrix and contains several copies of the mitochondrial DNA genome, mitochondrial ribosomes, and many other enzymes involved in respiration. Many amoeba have a contractile vacuole which helps them to regulate their osmotic pressure and get rid of excess water to prevent them from bursting. In eukaryotic cells, the cytoskeleton is a complex network of microfilaments, microtubules, and intermediate filaments that extend through the cytoplasm from the nucleus to the cell membrane. It provides a scaffolding function and is involved in many cellular processes, including mitosis, cell division, intracellular trafficking, and phagocytosis. The cell membrane is a phospholipid bilayer that is embedded with proteins. Amoeba do not have a cell wall, which allows the cell to be flexible and enables amoeba to move around and phagocytose their food using pseudopodia, which are dynamic cell projections, not fixed structures. Pseudopodia extend and retract via the assembly and disassembly of actin microtubules in the cytoskeleton. Amoeba use pseudopodia to move around their environment and to obtain food by phagocytosis.